Right. Here we go now. I'm going to try and sneak in. What's this? Oh, it's a hose. Will I turn the hose on?
Yeah. I can, like, maybe he can... Girls, ketchup out.
Maybe he can what?
He can get some ketchup out.
Get some ketchup out? Oh, get his ketchup out? Do you mean he's... What do you mean?
What do you mean? What's inside his body?
His blood ketchup.
That's funny.
I'm going to use that in future. Get this guy's ketchup out. Sometimes I wonder what Consolevania would have been like if me and Ryan and Cedar Living in Glasgow had lived somewhere like this, moved by Loch Lomond. I wonder what it would have been like. We'd have been out here all the time, I think, places like this. We'd have took a shot of this snowy mountain and we'd have probably just battered the Consolevania logo right across there. A bit of music in, obviously.
It's 2021. Problem is, I've no travelled into the next generation of consoles yet, so I'm just kinda bouncing around in no man's land, trying to justify. This is Old Man's Journey. And it's about an old man on a journey. And look, it looks good. It definitely looks good, but it's about as interactive as logging into your bank account. But it definitely does look good. It isn't new that what I'm saying is that the games I'm looking at, they're no new, I'm seeing what I missed in January of 2021. Apparently I missed this. You know, just watch the straight story instead of this. Watch that instead. It's much better. I mean, it looks good. It does look good. I mean, he's got shading and stuff in his colours. They're imbalanced, these indie games, is the thing. Good at some things, no as good at other things, that's the issue. But good God, Sunlight, even though it was, I think it was £3.50, £3.49, I think it was £3.49. I'll check my bank statement and I'll get back to you on that, but I think it was £3.49. Wasn't it worth £3.49? Because the voice acting's no very good, the writing's no very good, and that's all there is in the game, other than walking up to these flowers really slowly. And then listening to another bit of dodgy voice acting with some rough writing. I'm on a bit of a bad run with the games, not just indie games, but with the games. It's like five or six in a row, I'm like, what the fuck? Is this it? Like, this is the end of the game. And I'm like, is this it? Was that it? Is that what you've put on Steam? You put that on Steam? Is that it? Calling your games things like Old Man's Journey and I Am Dead, they should be right up my street. But then you look at I Am Dead, and it reminds me of Old Man's Journey in so much as it kinda looks like a Building Society advert. And have you ever watched a Building Society advert and thought, I'd really like to examine every asset in that animation in excruciating detail? Well, you should play I Am Dead, because that's what you're gonna be doing. Look at that. Definitely make, you'll never catch me saying don't make games. Definitely make games, but for Christ's sake, remember that fun's meant to be in there somewhere. even a wee tiny, tiny amount of it, but some, there's got to be some. It can't just be going through graphic menus, which is basically all this is. Examine. Bet there's a feather in that toolbox. I'll fucking bet you a tenner there's a feather in that toolbox. You dirty. Been looking for that for 45 minutes.
Encodia.
Encodia is a point and click PC game. It actually is new, it just came out a couple of days ago. And it's a cyberpunk type point and click. Do you know what cyberpunk is? Cyberpunk is... it was a projection of the future where everything was really shit, but now it's... there's a Brandenburg Gate there. I've been there. Brandenburg Gate. New cyberpunk is a projection of the future that's actually a lot, lot, lot better than things are actually going to be. I mean, there's humans on screen there that are still using their legs. 2062, and they're still using their legs. I don't think so. I don't think so. Atmospherically, Encodia is brilliant. Point and click wise is a bit of a pain in the arse. No being able to organise your inventory is an absolute bollock. And there's some combinations of items to solve some stuff that are just nonsense. I have a bad feeling that I might be quite hard to please when it comes to point and clicks. It's just not funny enough for me. It's just no.
Bates, I don't know why, but it sounds familiar.
That's not good enough for me. Maybe if you're half my age, which most people seem to be, but nah. Up your partner if you want to be a convincing point and click. Sorry mate, next. Next up is Donut County. I spelled it wrong, but... And this is a step up, because at the very least, being a hole is a lot more satisfying than I was expecting it was going to be. What they've done is, they've seen the amount of times you're playing a game and your wee man falls down a hole. Instead of concentrating on the character, the makers of this game have went, that's what it's called, Donut County. The makers of this game, oh fuck, I've spelt it wrong as well. The makers of this game have said, what's the backstory of that hole that I just fell down? What's his story? And that's what he plays the hole. Unfortunately, it's clogged up with a load of story that's a wee bit annoying, and Rob would have a field day with it, with all the meh 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 voices. So I cut all that out of this review and just concentrated on just being a dirty hole, but Dina being a big hole. Just being a big hole. I enjoyed it a lot more than I was expecting. Just being a big hole. Everything I've been playing is old anyway, so I thought I'd just show you some of my... Look at this, carry on. Bunch of shite bags. All jumping me at once. So I'll sneak up to him while he's asleep. Nice one. I have been playing this as well. And it's just... It's a borderline masterpiece. If it isn't already one. It's borderline. You just wander about, do what you want. Day dungeons, see dragons flying in the sky. It's unbelievable. Don't need a PS5. I think I might get a PS5.
It's Switch Ditch time. Let's take a look at some new entries in my Switch Ditch. First of all, we have to take a look at this Ori collector's set. Look at this, watch this look. Oh. Look at that! And inside this we have, we'll look at this in a minute, right? But we've got all this nice stuff. We've got wee pins, and we've got these are like little books, little guidebooks, and there's art cards, and here's the games themselves. Ori and the Blind Forest, Ori and the Will of the Wisps. But look, this. Stained glass. Look at that. Magical. In the previous episode, I reviewed Sukuna of Rice and Ruin, and this is the Golden Harvest edition of that. Let's have a look at what's inside here. As well as the game, we've got this soundtrack, and the soundtrack for Sukuna is absolutely beautiful, so that's a good one. We also have a big poster as well. Here's the big poster. This folds out. Now these are pointless, I kind of find, posters, because you're never going to put something in a frame that has these folds on it. I don't really get what you're supposed to do with these posters when they come. However, this is always
The best thing in any collector's edition is a big art book, and with the art in Sukuna being so beautiful, this is something that's essential, I would say, pal. An amazing set. Pick this one up. One of the best games ever as well. And finally, this week, we have got... Well, see, I used to call this game a list, right? I've called it a list. But I believe it's pronounced Aresta. That's how you're meant to say it. This is Aresta Collection. This is imported from Japan. It's another port that's been done by M2, who are the best at doing these shoot 'em up port jobs. And it has got some great old Game Gear stuff and a brand new game for the Game Gear on it. It's got a brand new Game Gear game on it, which is amazing. And this came with a wee magazine. I got it from Amazon Japan, and it came with this wee Aresta History magazine. Oh, that's a good one to have in the collection if you like your shoot-em-ups. And that's the Switch Ditch. Now, some of you might be going, what is this all about, the Switch Ditch thing? And, you know, sometimes it's just nice to anticipate something nice coming in the post when you're locked in like this and you're looking for. Now, what is that in my teeth? I mean, for fuck's sake. Oh, yuck. I mean, what? Hold on, digitise. Oh.
Do you see the little robin?
I consider myself a nice guy, you know. I know how lucky I am. I feel very fortunate every day. I'm happy. So why is that I love Hitman games so much? Why are Hitman games so good? What is it about them that I love so much? And why is it that when I play them, I enjoy just walking around the levels as much as I enjoy playing the game? Know what I mean? Hitman 3 starts in Dubai, a big fancy event in Dubai where lots of important people there. Hate spoiling this for you, but you skydive in at the start, climb in, change into your suit, cut a boot in this gorgeous big building. And the first thought, obviously, it jumps into your head is these guys are going to make an incredible James Bond game. I think Hitman 3 smoothly emerging onto the market. A perfect launch. Kind of unassuming wee launch, actually. Landed on his all. And I think it did that when it did, just after the Cyberpunk debacle of last year, where that game was kicked out the door way too early. After a development team suffered for years trying to make it, came out and was a total shambles, needing loads of fixes. And that was a game about building a world. About building a world that you were going to enjoy spending time in, a world that felt like it was alive. And yet, that world in Cyberpunk just felt like a facade. It was fake, didn't work, falling apart at the seams. Too ambitious, some people could say. Well, look at Hitman 3.
Enjoy the experience, sir.
What makes Hitman 3 a best-in-class video game is that they understand what world-building actually is supposed to be. It's not supposed to be about building the biggest place with the most people in it. It's supposed to be about building a believable place that feels like it's alive.
47. I would like to address the Providence partners directly.
It's supposed to be about building a world that you can immerse yourself in.
And I have an idea, but it requires
a world that doesn't feel like it's just hanging on a sugary peg, and any wee stiff wind is going to make all the walls fall down. I'm not allowed in here. So I'll leave.
Right there. That's Marcus Stuyvesant, Providence partner, self-entitled and arrogant little worm.
See, the Hitman games are games where you understand the rules completely. You understand what you can do and what you can't. You understand what you should do and what you must do. And you understand that there's a whole series of cause and effect things that you need to manipulate to make your plans come to fruition. You're not going to get surprised by stupid logic or poor AI or again that thing of somebody trying to build a world that impresses by its sheer scale but doesn't stand up to any scrutiny. The Hitman games stand up to scrutiny, and because they stand up to scrutiny and because the rule set of this game is so clearly defined, you can have so much fun with it. And that's really what the Hitman games are all about. Weirdly, as kind of po-faced as they look on the surface, and it does look at first glance like a kind of po-faced, sorry, it shouldn't have been this private bar. It looked kind of po-faced on the surface, but man, the games are just such fun. And I could talk for hours about how good these levels are. In Hitman 3, there are only 6 levels, but they're so replayable. 6 worlds that you can play around in and take different approaches, hit different targets. And there's also all these wee storylines that play out. You can learn so much about the world just by walking around and eavesdropping on people. And I've had everybody watching me play this game. I've had my wife watching me play it. We're tanning a bottle of wine, playing through it together. She was making suggestions, laughing at me when I was clumsily trying to snap people's necks. Maybe nowhere is the brilliance of Hitman 3 exhibited as much as when you're in here in this nightclub in Berlin. Let's walk back outside a wee sec. There's your bouncers on the door.
What if I slipped you a little sweetener under the table?
There's your queue of people trying to get in. Now the world building here is, this isn't specifically based on, it's no modelled after any specific nightclub, but there is a nightclub in Berlin that's like this. It's off the beaten track. When I was playing this, I was playing it, my wife was watching me play it. And I said, well, I'm here in Berlin now. And she'd already been watching me through the previous level, was loving watching it, and that's something you can say about Hitman 3, or any of the Hitman games really, they're great fun to watch. And when this level started, you are on a road beside a petrol station, and then you need to go to this club that's off the beaten track. And before this even happened, I went, and this is before I knew it was even a nightclub level, I said to my wife, I'm in Berlin. I'm on this road, I've got to walk down here through the bushes to find, and my wife says to me, maybe it's a nightclub down there. When I was in Berlin, there was this mad nightclub that was kind of like, you had to just, the taxi would drop you off and then you would have to kind of walk down, and it was just like in the middle of nowhere. And down we walked, and there we were, in the nightclub. Which was amazing for her. Also really interesting for me as well. It was like interesting to see that kind of world building that works by the level just suggesting itself, like suggesting what its influences are.
Hey, sorry to just bust into your incredibly long Hitman 3 review, but I had to talk to you about something. In my family, right, Hitman has become a bit of a thing in my family. Everybody loves watching it, like I've said, my wife, my daughters, everybody likes watching Daddy playing Hitman and making the ketchup come out of people's bodies. But one of the things we talk about a lot, I talk about particularly with my three-year-old a lot, is how realistic it would be to be able to just sneak into a place and kill a guy without anybody spotting you or anybody seeing you. And we talk about this a lot. And I just thought it was interesting that while I was recording some of the footage for that review, there was a guy just outside my window and I had no idea I was there. That guy could be Hitman. This guy, I'm talking about this guy. I'll show you him. I didn't even realise he was there. Did you notice him? That could... I mean, that's how he does it, right? I need to tell her about you.
Now, here's a bit of the review. Well, I just go into a trance while I'm capturing footage because I'm remembering what it was like to be in a nightclub. Also thinking about the fact that nightclubs might never exist again. Look at my face! Magic, wasn't it? Look at him! What a shame.
It's just a precaution.
I've been personally invited by the Royal Highness Omar Al-Ghazali. I should have clearance. The name is Zainab Kazim.
Sir, I understand.
Loads of characters just mingling with each other in this world. Some of them instantly flagging themselves as assholes that you want to knock out and steal their clothes.
Come back if you want. I'll be waiting upstairs in the reception. Understood.
I can't recommend this enough because I've always been a fan of the Hitman games. I've reviewed a Hitman game before in Consolevania. Hitman Blood Money. My previous favourite before this one. And I just feel this is like a lap of honour, this game. This is what I would call it. It's a lap of honour because it doesn't really reinvent what the Hitman games do. It just does what the Hitman games do so well and does it to a perfect shine. And you can, if you already own Hitman 1 and 2, this is a PlayStation 5 version of Hitman 3, it'll upgrade your old levels for you so you can play through them on one big set. It's an endless supply of beautiful, beautiful murder.
You are sick.
This guy's an asshole, by the way. Guy with a green shawl. Can't ignore that guy. The weird thing about playing Hitman games nowadays, though, is that you say to yourself, maybe I'll never be able to be in a place like this in real life anymore. Maybe this is how we do tourism in the future.
Greetings, sir.
Maybe we're going to have to depend on developers like this to create these worlds for us to explore. Because we... I mean, when's the next time you're going to go to a big fancy hotel event in Dubai, mate? You can think about that. Think on that for a minute. When's the next time you're going to be able to do that? So there it is. Look, let's even get your fancy modern graphics now in that. A game that doesn't really need it, but, you know, like I said, it makes the world you're spending time in just look so much nicer, doesn't it?
So sore.
That? These shiny puddles and all that, it's beautiful, isn't it? Shiny baldy head. Man, I have loved the time I've spent playing Hitman 3, and I've still got so much left to do in this game. And I'm going to be playing through that beautiful selection box of all those other levels and stuff like that for a long, long time. I really suggest that you play this, if only just to remind yourself of what making a great game is meant to be all about. It's meant to about be having a mastery over what you can do. Having a mastery over that. No being the kind of arsehole that over-promises about what the world of your game is going to be like, how big it's going to be, how amazing it's going to be, how much it sprawls,
how many characters there are, how many storylines there are. Just like, my God. Just work out what you're capable of doing and do it brilliantly well. That's all anybody's asking. That's all anybody wants. Please. Just do something good.
I want the truth to come out so that this psychopathic evil can cease to control human society. And that's my goal, that's been my commitment all along, and I'm not interested in a round of applause or a frickin' statue, thank you. I'm saying here what I've seen to be true over a long period of time.
I'm starting to wonder if my game collection's big enough. Is that big enough? It's normally it's big enough, but there's a lockdown on just now. And they're building a fence around my fucking running track during a lockdown. They're building a fence around my running track. I mean, it is a collection of the best, most fulfilling games that exist. Am I thinking about this too much? I can't tell if I'm thinking about this too much. Maybe I need a plan. I'll make a plan and that'll make me feel better.
To what actually has manifested over the last 4 years. I think people have got to start rethinking Trump as well.
Hey guys, welcome to the new regular section of the show where I'm going to be inviting you into... I think these lockdowns have been hitting us all pretty hard. It's mentally good for mental health, I think, to spend time with your family unless they're assholes. I've had an absolutely fantastic idea that I'm going to share with you, and that is that if you don't have a family or you don't see your family because they don't like you, you can just make your own one. You can just make your own lockdown family. Here it is, Ryan's lockdown family. Come and welcome yourself into it. Hey guys. Don't be cheeky.
Starting the family day right, me, the wife and kids like to get as much news into us as possible, just to set the tone for the day.
Someone's been robbed.
One thing that has really surprised me is how much more energy I've got now that I've got a new family. They're just all kind of bouncing off each other, kind of a lot better. Sorry. You know, you go first. I had to take in a lodger to make a bit of money. He just keeps himself to himself, I don't... He's like...
Activate and tense the muscles of your inner thighs to help you use your lower abs.
You know, this is going to sound incredibly naive, but until my wife, Daisy Fuentes Pilates, moved in, I didn't even know I had lower abs. What a difference it makes to your life to be able to just have some family fun, just gather around a board game and escape what's happening right now. Sometimes even the wife's sister, Telly Addicts on the PSP, comes over for a game.
Guys, I think this is going to be too adult for our youngest son, Croc Legend of the Gobbles. You might need to go to bed, Croc Legend of the Gobbles. This is too old for you.
It's a wee bit confusing because Croc Legend of the Gobbles is my youngest son, but he's also the oldest game in the family. The companionship and emotional support that I get from my family these days is second to none. An afternoon nap is nothing short of healing, although recently there has been a dangerous build-up of static in the bed sheets.
I smell high karate.
Why is everyone around here a cock and rope pedo face?
Swing in the sway, I got all the moves.
I don't really know what you want.
I'm really glad that you chose to learn Pilates. You know, no other system of exercise out there does what Pilates does. It makes your muscles longer.
I'm worrying if I'm having too much fun now with the family. I can't even keep a straight face telling my son Void Bastards off for his language. If anything, I think I'm proud of my son's unique sense of humour. Jackie Chan Stuntmasters, conspiracy theories are getting a bit out of control. I'm just starting to avoid him now.
Oi, twat face.
I was stuck sitting listening to him for 4 hours the other night as he was trying to explain to me how it's elves that own Facebook and Twitter. But to be honest, by the end of it, he had that many graphs and stuff that I wasn't actually sure if he was wrong. As much as I've enjoyed preparing food for my family, Jackie Chan's stuntmaster's put some ideas into my head and I'm starting to wonder if he's right. What have I done? Is this a real family?
Who's going to find it here?
Ah,
I've seen this clip for 73 times now.
In 100 years from now, this probably won't be a field with grass.
Even when you get top marks in the wife's sister telematics on the PSP's quiz, she asks you to take it again and see if you can do better.
So why not have another go and see if you can do even better?
I'm beginning to wonder if it wouldn't have been better for society if I hadn't built this video game Bond family.
Where do I go for the colonic meal plan?
I was too busy thinking about whether I could build a video game Bond family. I didn't think about whether I should. Well, I...